I got this old drill press, but there are some problems I need to solve. I will start by checking the motor. For that I need to change these old wires, they are no longer safe to use. I quickly connected new wires to check the motor. Motor is working, that's a great start. I just need to change the bearings, they are very loud. But by far the biggest problem is that this drill is too big for this table. So I want to change the position of the motor, but I have no idea if it will work. Let's find out. I will start by removing motor and motor bracket. Someone made this bracket to be able to attach another type of motor. These bolts are for belt cover, but I don't have it, so I don't need them. Now I need to remove this belt tensioner. I need the side flat for motor bracket. That was easy. Mark and drill new holes. For drilling I use my homemade drill press. It's kinda handy in size. If you are interested in building one, you can find video on my channel. Mark drilled on top of the holes there. I put everything back together to check if the motor will not interfere with anything in that position. It looks like everything works with the new motor position, so I can continue work with the rest. I want to change the bearings for the motor and paint it. For that I need to take everything apart. All the bolts are rusted, so I used some penetrating oil to loosen them more easily. I couldn't loosen this bolt, so I had to drill it out. I used a hammer and block of wood to safely remove the pulley. The motor is held together by these three bolts. This is a cap that is meant to protect the bearings from dirt, but I don't see any seals in them. Probably more intended for easier access to grease the bearings. You can tell these bearings are old as motor because they are not shielded. I will also change the bearings for the spindle. I just need to remove more broken bolts. There should be a return spring inside, but it looks like it has never been there. This broken clamping part is another problem that needs to be solved. Next, I will remove quill and change spindle bearings. You can only remove quill pinion shaft in one position. After removing shaft, you can take out the quill. After unscrewing the lock nut, I'm removing spindle from the quill using a hammer. I put the spindle in the vise and remove these bearings as well. Based on the markings, I can tell these bearings were changed in the same way in the past. And lastly, I removed bearings from the pulley. I disassembled everything else so that it can be easily cleaned. I put all the parts in a container and washed them using diesel and a brush to remove the old grease. I tried to remove rust from the base plate using Scotch Brite, but rust was too deep, therefore I used wire brush and hand drill instead. I apply masking tape to the place I don't want to paint. I use metallic paint that can be painted directly on the rust. It's time to assemble everything together. I really like how easy it is to put together asynchronous motors, and it's difficult to assemble them incorrectly. I like to use new bolts whenever I can, because I am not a hardcore restorer who sticks only to original parts. With some magic of editing, I mount bearings for spindle. Yes, I know how to correctly mount bearings, and in this case you need to press on the outer ring. However, I only had a hammer, so beat it. There is a groove in the quill, but there is no set screw to secure it from rotating, that's why I'm drilling it. Tapping cast iron is the second best thing I like to tap after a mark. Anyway, I made this set screw using drill and belt grinder. I don't know how often I will use depth gauge, but I would like this option to work when I really need it. I made new handles because each old one was different. I'm using regular spring here because I can't find new return spring for this drill. The drill was moving sideways freely because there was no cant to hold it in place. And I have the first opportunity to test the drill at work. While drilling, I found a problem that without a case the drill has unnecessary movement in this direction. Got a little better, but while we are up here I couldn't pass the chance to lose a finger, so I used a scotch brite to clean the spoolie by hand. The free movement also occurs because I can't clamp this hard enough. I will repair it with this treated rod because I have no experience welding cast iron. Yes, I drilled too high, and now everything looks uneven, but clamping forces are much greater now. But anyway, I'm pleased with the outcome. Now I have proper drill press and it also fits on my workbench.